1, verse 21. Soul. But these people out here, this is the congregation of the dead. Alright? They're following an empire that's soon about to be destroyed. That's what the Heavenly Father told us what? To come up out of my people. Because wickedness is at an all-time high in this place. That's how we know we're living at the latter end. Okay? Because we see the signs that's happening. When they pass that constitutional right to allow homosexuals to marry, we know this place is out of here, man. Any kingdom that allows that type of behavior, that kingdom is destroyed. The Heavenly Father is not with this place. He never was. Because this place is wicked as hell, man. And you saw from Negroes and Hispanics, you don't took on the nature of America. You don't took on the nature of that one. That's why the scripture says to lay a hold on filthiness and naughtiness. What? To prevent you to be converted. Alright? Not only that, verse 22. But be ye doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving your own selves. Alright? Verse 22, man. That's what I'm just talking about, man. A lot of you niggas are effeminate, man. Get a scripture on that. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9. You got all kind of niggas walking out all fagged out, man. You ain't gonna make it, man. The Heavenly Father's not dealing with men like that, man. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9. That the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of the Most High. Be not deceived, neither fornicators, which is what sexual immorality, or the worshiping of other gods, is spiritual culture. No idolaters, okay, bow down to idols, like Islam, Roman Catholic Church. Islam, they bow down to that damn rock over there in Mecca. Catholic Church brought on to what? All kinds of idols. That's idolatry. Okay, that's the second commandment. Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven images of any likeness, man. That's in heaven above, but that's in the earth. But that's in the water under the earth. That's idolatry. So the scripture says, if you went to fornication or idolatry, keep reading. Nor adulterers. Okay, laying with another man's wife. A woman's cheating on her husband. That's idolatry. That's adultery. Okay? And that's all these Negroes sing about in their R&B songs or their rap songs. And they brag about it. Guess what? You're an adulterer. And the scripture says you will not inherit the kingdom of God. All right, keep reading. Nor effeminate, which is a man that take on the qualities of a female, man. A faggot, man. The scripture says if you're effeminate, you ain't gonna make it. Especially the times that's about to hit this country. Nor abusers of themselves with mankind, homosexuality. Nor thieves, nor covetous. It's just a sign of what other men have, or what other people have. That's being covetous. Alright? Nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor extortionists shall inherit the kingdom of the heavenly Father. So you can't do none of those things, man. Alright? Says, yea, they made their hearts as an adamant stone, lest they should hear the law and the words which the Lord of hosts have sent in the spirit by the former prophets. Therefore came a great wrath from the Lord of hosts, and when that wrath is about to approach, Jacob's trouble is about to approach. Well, a lot of you so-called Negroes and Hispanics, you can get quartered off in concentration camps. Okay? The King Alfred Klan gonna be in full effect. And 2/3 you're gonna get cut off right here in America. Right here in Babylon. Because like the scripture says, you made your heart as an adamant stone. Your hard head, your stiff neck, and your rebellious. Okay? Keep reading. Therefore, it has come to pass that as he cried, they would not hear. Read that again. Verse 13. Therefore, it has come to pass that as he cried, they would not hear. And how does the Heavenly Father cry out to you, man? When we come out here on the highways and hedges. Because the prophets or the apostles are the mouthpiece of the one you call God and Yahawashi or his son. You got a job to do. So when we come out here and cry or prophesy, you don't hearken and neither do you listen. Okay, every week we got to get on you guys, man. Because judgment is right around the corner. So the blood is off our hands. Keep reading. Therefore, it has come to pass that as he cried, they would not hear. So they cried, and I would not hear, saith the Lord of hosts. So when a lot of you are getting put in them concentration camps, because Obama passed the NDAA, the NDRP, which 90% of people out here don't even know what that is. Majority of people out here don't even know the microchip is an Obamacare. Majority of people don't even know that the Bohemian Grove was last week. majority of people don't even know that they militarized the police. Because they too busy being what? Entertained by foolishness, man. Wearing some colorful bullshit, man. See that? That's the two-thirds club. Fucking spick. Anyway. Yeah, America's going down, man. And a white man with it. Alright? That's the message. That's the good news. Matthew chapter 11, verse 19. See, the scripture says we're made a spectacle unto men. All right? Because why? We waking back up to who we are. The truth that was hid for so long is now what? Is now being brought back into the earth. But it's only meant for the elect to get it. All right? And the elect is waking up, man. I must say, man. When you look on YouTube, you got brothers all over the globe out there pushing this truth. Right? But two-thirds ain't gonna get it. Matthew 11 and 19. Let me start from verse 17. And saying, we have piped unto you, and he have not danced. How we piping unto you? By preaching this word. Because this is the real song right here. Not jumping up and down in church every Sunday. Okay? That's not praising the Lord, man. And that's not the real Lord you worship in anyway. First of all, in order to praise the Heavenly Father in truth, you have to know His name. And you have to know His Son's name. And that's another thing, you have to glorify the Son. Because you got reprobates online, don't believe in Yahawashi no more. And that's what you guys, you're going to utterly be destroyed. You can put your money on that. If you don't accept Yahawashi, you would not make it. Okay? But anyway, Matthew chapter 11, verse 17. And saying, we have piped unto you, and ye have not danced. We have mourned unto you, and ye have not lamented. Verse 18. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they said he hath a devil. So John the Baptist was a Nazarite. So he came preaching one way. America gonna be destroyed, man. You guys can't save America, man. It's a waste of time, bro. Total waste of time. Alright? We keep reading. The Navy idiots, man. Verse 18. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they said he have a devil. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, oh, a man gluttonous and a wine bibber, a friend of publicans and sinners. But wisdom is justified of her children. So every time the prophets came out and spoke, John and he never listened. They said that what? They were the devil, or you guys preaching hate. Once you preach love, and they don't even know what love is. When a white man ever showed you so-called Negroes and Hispanics love, man. Ever. But he's the first one to come up here and talk about love. He's a hypocrite. And that's why his empire is going to go out with fire. Okay? Thank you. spirit is really dead today.
I don't know what's going on, man.
The word, nothing is in vain, man. Right? The scripture says every labor has a reward. Looks like a lot of people went on vacation this week. But anyway, John chapter... get the scripture.
You see the guy?
Yeah.
See the guy? Yep. Listen, anybody have a problem with what I'm saying? Come up, man. Don't just sit there. See what I'm saying? Men of the Most High, we don't back down from anybody, man. And let me get this scripture. To God, man. Hispanics, you start waking up, man. Which a lot of you are. Alright? Matter of fact, let me read the scripture. Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 7. It's time for you Hispanic tribes, you Latin tribes, Puerto Ricans, Dominicans, you Native Indians, down to you Mexicans. Okay, you South Americans are Indian descent through your father. Okay, you guys are Israelites as well. But a lot of you went to idol worship. All right? Ezekiel chapter 37. Okay, this is the prophet's job right here. In fact, before I read that, Jeremiah 29, verse 15. quick scripture, Jeremiah 29 and 15. Because he hath said, the Lord has raised us up prophets in Babylon. Okay, the Most High is raising up prophets in Babylon. Okay? And what are you supposed to do when we come out here? Because you had some Latinos came, or quote unquote, so-called, they're really from the Northern Kingdom. They looked at the sign, man. And they looked at the martial law sign. Number one, we have to try to gather all 12 tribes. He elected them. The remnant. Alright? Ezekiel chapter 37. Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 15. The word of the Lord came again unto me, saying, moreover, thou son of man, take thee one stick and write upon it. For Judah, who's the kingdom of Judah? You so-called Negroes, West Indians, and you Haitians. Okay, you're the southern kingdom. Alright? And for the children of Israel, his companions, then take another stick and write upon it for Joseph, the stick of Ephraim. That's you so-called Dominicans, Cubans, Puerto Ricans. You North Americans, you Reubenites. Alright? You, which are the Seminole Indians. You Asherites, Naphtali, which is basically the whole entire South America and Mexico, man. But of course, Panama, Central America. Because it was written that all 12 tribes have come on this side of the world and we're all sold slavery together. But it tells you in the latter end, he elected them, was going to get redeemed. So the scripture says we have to come out here and make two sticks. One for Judah and his brethren, and the other for the northern kingdom. Alright? Because we got a lot of dudes online teaching that Hispanics are not Israelites. They are Israelites. Okay? Keep reading. And Ephraim for all the house of Israel, his companions, and join them one to another into one stick, and they shall become one in thine hand. Alright? Verse 10. So I prophesied, and he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived. And what's the breath? The knowledge. That's what it means that the Most High breathed into Adam's lungs. Let's talk, that's symbolic, man. That means he gave him the law, statutes, and commandments. Above all, we're giving you your nationality. And we're letting you know the name of the Heavenly Father, and His Son, and the Eagle. Those are the keys to salvation. That's the manual on how to be saved. And above all, you got to endure. Right? You keep reading. Read it again. Verse 10. So I prophesied, and he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived and stood upon their feet an exceeding great army. Okay, because we're going to be the ruling body of the world to come. The 144,000. That's going to be the ruling body under one world, the world English called Jesus Christ. Or Yahawashi, his real name. We're going to set things straight and make things right. But in order to receive that glory, we got to endure.